Welcome back to my channel, guys. In this video, I just want to share with you guys some of my self-care routine, and I hope I will be able to share with you some tips on how to take care of yourself and how to take care of your body, of your mind, because it's very important, especially in this time of crisis, especially in this time that we're just staying at home, like we're not able to go out, eat out, or hang out with our friends. We're not able to travel. We're not able to work. As in, hindi na natin lahat nagagawa ngayon freely. So for me, it's essential that we have to take care of ourselves, because ang tendency when we're just at home, you know, gonna eat a lot or sit and watch Netflix for like the whole day, and also sometimes nakakatamad maligo or nakakatamad na gumawa ng anything because we're just at home and nobody's like watching, nobody's gonna visit, or you know, we don't have to dress up, or for girls hindi na kailangan mag makeup. So I just thought of like sharing with you guys like how to take care of yourself and what are the ways that we can take care of ourselves na nasa bahay lang tayo. So yeah, my number one is plan your day ahead of time. What I usually do is, especially when I want to be very productive the next day, I always write everything down in my notebook and also in my iPhone notes, like everything that I have to do the next day. So basically, like that's the night before. So for today, I already wrote everything down last night. In my notebook, I have this prioritization, like I have a priority list and what to do the next day. Like for example, now I wrote it down, like I have to vlog, or I have to write a script on what's gonna be the next content of my vlog. And also, in my notes, I write everything down, like from morning to evening, on what I'm gonna do. The purpose of like writing everything down or of planning everything ahead is, it's like you have a structure, you have a plan or a direction on what to do the next day. Basically, guys, I write everything, like what time do I have to wake up, what time do I have to work out, what will I eat, what will I do in a specific hour, or also praying, I write that. I write everything down, plan everything ahead of time, so I just have to follow what I write. What I told you, I write everything down. So dito nakasulat niyan sa cellphone ko. Like today is Wednesday. So last night I wrote na like wake up at 8 a.m., pray, workout for 2 hours minimum. Tapos lahat talaga yan, like drink supplements, film the workout, eat in proper portions, eat healthy. So lahat yan nakasulat. Even yung pag-vlog ko today, nakasulat yan. If you want to be more productive, if you want to be more organized the next day, and also if you don't want to waste your time, you have to plan and write down everything. So yeah, that's my number one very important tip. And number two, part of like taking care of myself or taking care of yourself is waking up early. Me, I would consider myself as an early riser. I always wake up early. When I wake up early, I feel like I have like more energy to do everything for the whole day. I don't know, I'm just excited to like and make use of my time for the whole day and do some productive stuff like reading or planning things ahead. But sa mga hindi naman nasanay na maaga gumising, I think it's okay as long as you start your day right and make use of your time wisely. For those who are working at home, find some time to also be more active and exercise. My third tip is pray. Lagi ko na itong inuulit-ulit. When I wake up in the morning, I always pray. I don't know, I just thank God for everything, for the life, for the luxury of just staying at home while the others are risking their lives to protect other people. It seems so easy, no, when you hear the word praying, parang wala lang, or ang simple lang siyang gawin. But it's not. It's very hard. It's hard to be consistent. It's hard to pray genuinely, seriously, especially pag nasa bahay ka lang. It's hard, right? So part of taking care of our soul, of our spiritual aspect in life, is to always talk to God, to always connect to Him. And I'm just grateful for everything, guys. I have the time to be with my husband. I have the time to be with my family, you know, with all the available resources that we have, like my food naman, meron din gym where we can work out. So I just really pray for everything and for the people na alam kong sobrang affected ngayon. And yeah, sinali ko talaga to siya, guys. Number 3 siya, but actually isa siya sa pinaka-importante ngayon that we have to really pray for everyone. We have to pray for our frontliners. We have to pray for our family who are abroad, who are not with us, for our friends, and also for the homeless, the hungry people. You know, every time I watch the videos na mga taong mga walang nakakain ngayon, walang trabaho, and walang mahigaan, alam ko nakakaiyak ng sobra, but for now I can't do anything because I'm just at home. So the best thing that we can do, which is the most important and the most powerful thing, is to pray for them, to pray for everyone. Aside from praying, we have to do a lot of reflecting and repentance sa time na to. Kasi somehow I believe that God really wants us to reflect on our sins. We have made a lot of destruction sa earth, sa lahat. I mean, we have been sinners ever since. But siguro, like, sa time na to talaga, grabe na yung mga nangyayari. So, I think God wanted us to stop doing. Merong message for sure si God, and each one of us should reflect and analyze and share to others, like, kung ano yung mga natutunan natin. Kung hindi man tayo nagpe-pray with our family at home, kung sinong my courage or kung sino yung kaya or dapat talaga kayanin, guys, to encourage our family members to pray together and to use this time na makarealize at sana mabago tayo as, you know, as human being, because I think it's gonna be a whole different world after this. Number 4, guys, is exercise. For me, it's very important that we have to exercise. I know that we are all at home now, but it's important that we have to move, we have to work out, and kung mayroon naman kayong internet sa bahay, it's so easy to search sa YouTube kung ano yung exercise na gusto nyong gawin for the day. Like me, I search some Pilates videos or mga abs exercises videos, and most of the time, I do treadmill. It's very important that we have to stay healthy, we have to stay fit, and we have to move kasi nasa bahay lang tayo, and ang tendency is nagiging tamad talaga kumilos. Pwede naman din na pag sobrang busog kayo, you can just like walk around, you burn some calories. For me, hindi lang dapat yung physical yung ini-exercise natin. I also believe that we have to exercise our brains. It's important these days that we have to stay sane, and we have to study a lot, and we have to learn a lot while we are at home, because we have to be ready for the outside world after this quarantine or lockdown, right? Hindi pwedeng wala tayong natutunan while we are at home. So I multitask sometimes while working out. I watch documentaries, especially pag nagde-treadmill ako. Also, I listen to podcasts. It's nice to exercise and learn at the same time. So, mga 1 week ng quarantine, I ended up watching K-drama. Like, I would finish 10 or 8 episodes sa isang araw. And I realized right away that it was not a good thing for me. So, I decided and I had to plan everything out na kailangan. I have to listen to some good podcasts and I have to watch mga nice documentaries na good source for learning. So, it's important that we exercise our brains too and at the same time, our body. So my number 5 self-care tip is to talk to your friends and connect to your loved ones. Wala lang, it's nice to check up on them. Ngayon, pwede naman na tayong mag-FaceTime, pwede naman nang magtawagan every day or anytime. So we have to check everyone. Like what I do, I always call my family in Bohol. It helps with my parang sadness sometimes. It helps with my sanity. My family keeps me happy, energized, and you know, it just helped me to become more positive despite everything. So I talk to my sister and her family in the States, and also my friends from wherever, and also my family in Australia. So yeah, I always like check up on them. I always like talk to my friends and FaceTime with them. Sometimes nag-games pa kami sa Messenger. Yeah, it just makes everything lighter, and okay din na we get to connect with them and ask them like ano yung mga perspective nila, anong mga realization nila sa mga nangyayari ngayon. And you know, you just give encouragement and positivity to your family and to your friends. So for me, it's very important to connect to other people kahit na hindi man physically together. thank you so much guys for watching, and I hope you guys like my video. And I just want to say thank you to all our frontliners out there, sa lahat ng mga tumutulong, sa lahat-lahat ng mga nandyan sa labas at nagtatrabaho. Thank you so much guys for everything. May God bless you, and we will continue to pray for you. Till next vlog, thank you guys. And thank you for my husband. Thank you sa pag-play ng piano. Kahit saglit lang. Hindi niya alam na kinuha na siya. Okay.